This year we have 1,000 students, 103 institutions, 150 faculty mentors, 75 life building projects. A new generation of young professionals who will transform the face of the building sector in India.
Ramya. I'm the team lead of Team eCash, and we are all students from School of Planning and Architecture, Vijayawada.
I am Amukta Malyoga. I am a master student doing sustainable architecture. I play the role of a designer.
My name is Hema Malini. I am a master student in SPA Vijayawada. So I am in the metrics team. Basically, I take care of simulations and energy calculations.
I'm Darshit Mehta, and I'm also a master student doing my post-graduation in building engineering and management from SPA Vijayawada. Currently, I'm working on marketing, affordability, and cost estimation.
I'm Veronica, and I'm pursuing my master's in sustainable architecture.
Our project basically is a house, EcoPod. It is designed to inspire its occupants to embrace a more community and a simple living lifestyle. The house basically caters to a very family and people-centric design, whereas the structure is very resilient and future-ready.
So our project partner is Navira, based on the ideology of Saptapada, or the seven strands of sustainability. They cater to people who want to be close to nature and want to be aware of the way they produce and consume the resource. And we are working on EcoPod in the same spirit of sustainability.
We began developing a project proposal that is self-sufficient and which functions on an off-grid power system.
We're envisioning like an ideal peri-urban scenario. We have not only thought about self-sufficiency in energy and water, but also in food. What we are envisioning as social sustainability will deal with how we produce our resources, how we're going to use our resources, and what we do with the surplus resources. And in terms of cost, we're bringing about this circular economy, sort of embracing both the residents of the place as well as the people surrounding it. Even our site would sort of embrace the surrounding farmers and the local produce, and that will really boost the economy of that place.
We have also taken measures to introduce eco-sensitivity. We discovered and partnered with a company called Green Jam for walling material. They manufacture agri-crete that is made out of agro-waste. Our project site is mostly barren, and we have introduced native vegetation to enhance biodiversity.
In college, we've been designing a very academic, research-based project. But now we've learned to integrate these research study, surveying the market for products, talking to manufacturers, and learning from industry experts. What was also very exciting is the fact that we learned different approaches to sustainability. For example, our project partner has the Saptapada concept of sustainability, including land and people and food. Whereas our industry partners, we have an international industry partner, Passive House Institute. They're based in Germany. They have a different approach to sustainability.
So Red Kitchen India is giving us the knowledge base, which is essential to arm ourselves against climate change. And in this process, we have been exposed to the methods of designing resilient and self-sufficient habitats.
It creates an awareness within me, and I'll spread it to people I know. And this, in a way, will allow to create a demand within various users asking for a green building or asking for a sustainable building. I was very much excited because saying someone that you can generate your own electricity and use it and you don't need to be dependent on water or electricity, that becomes an excellent idea. Practically everyone wants to be self-sufficient. As soon as this competition takes up and people start talking about it, there would be an impact in large proportions where people would ask for sustainable building.
Since we're designing very modularly, the built form as well as the parcel of land and the services that's integrated is envisioned to be scalable in any form of like tropical climate. Another thing that's scalable is also our business model. How we deal with agriculture, how we deal with biodiversity, and how we deal with the economy behind all of that.
I as users, we feel more accountable for the resources we use. And measuring or metering is the first step to sustainability. And I think it has become something that we are slowly trying to incorporate for ourselves.
While learning these 10 modules that have been focusing on individual aspects of sustainability, we found specific niche areas where we can develop and take like research further and sort of focus even in our future how we apply, you know, our learnings for solar detection.
I really started incorporating the knowledge of indoor air quality within my room. So I started bringing all those indoor office plants into my room.
This has given us a way to take more informed decisions where we're not just randomly throwing in design solutions, but it's more informed.
The concept of Durbin is rural and urban living.
Even being in an urban context, we have multiple housing in the same area, but everyone has an individual life, which is not there in a rural environment. We have started looking at people-centric approach to bring in people and be a part of the same level or the same community. That's also something that Durbin addresses. We already are at a stage where we are going to have an energy crisis, but we don't talk about it. So when we bring in an approach of self-sufficiency in our project, the people who are living in that project are very much endorsing that idea. And once if we add affordability to the idea of self-sufficiency, it becomes a lifestyle.
The name of our team is eCache. E stands for energy, ecology, economy. Cache means contained.
The cache idea was basically stored or hidden, which means a deceptively simple design could also be extremely responsive, adaptive, and resilient.